So let's take a look at each of these policies, types of policies, in more detail. So the first policy we are looking at is the our blocking policies. So blocking policies are engaged instantaneously at the gateway level itself when an API is invoked, and they are evaluated at tenant level. So blocking policies can be created using the following parameters. So the first one would be the API context. Basically what this would result in is it would block all requests for a particular API. And so this can come in handy if you want to temporarily block a given API from being invoked for whatever reason. And then you have the next attribute that the that blocking policies can be used against is application level. So so you could configure a particular application. You could essentially block requests from a particular application itself that is invoking that API. And then we have the IP address. So you can specify a set of IP addresses, and any requests that arrive from that any of those specific IP addresses will be blocked. And the final attribute available out of the box for blocking conditions to work is the user. So if a specific user makes an API invocation request, if you've got a blocking condition set up for that user, you can prevent that user from invoking the API. So next, let's take a look at advanced or API level throttling. So as I mentioned earlier, these types of policies can be applied for the entire API or at API resource level. So you can allocate the quota account at the following levels. So for example, like I mentioned, you can do it at the API or the resource level. So what that means is that all users will share the number of requests that have been configured for that particular policy. So if, for example, if you've set a policy, for example, like 10 requests per minute, and it's applied at either API or resource level, API resource level, then all users using that API will be limited to 10 requests per minute in total. And then you can actually set the limit for user level. So what this means is that instead of that, the API throttling limit applying to all users globally, you can ensure that it gets set for a per user basis. So that means is if you set the user level for 10 requests per minute, if you have three users, each of those users will be able to invoke the API for 10 at a rate of 10 requests per minute. So the total potential would be would be 30, because you've got that limit set at a per user level. So you can also apply advanced throttling using a concept called conditional groups. So what these conditional groups are pretty much is a set of attributes that are available out of the box that you can actually apply a policy against. So we have IP address or IP range based throttling, HTTP header based throttling, query parameter based throttling, and JWT condition based throttling. So for example, if I could just talk a bit about the JWT condition throttling. So API manager allows you to actually send out JWT user attributes or claims via JWT to the backend. So you can actually write throttling policies against those particular claims that are contained in the JWT that is generated as well. And you can add multiple combinations of these conditional groups and use them in tandem. Next, let's take a look at the subscription throttling with burst controlling. So these are applied per a subscription basis. Basically what will happen is that all the users that are using a particular API subscription will be affected by the particular throttling level that has been set for a subscription throttling policy. So you can do both request count and bandwidth based throttling at this policy level, and the key that is used to identify a particular subscription is the application ID, the API context, and the API version. So the combination of those three uniquely identify a particular subscription that a subscription policy will be engaged against. So the burst control feature of this particular throttling policy level allows you to actually prevent abnormal usage of an API that might take place if there are a higher number of invocations for that API during a very short amount of time. So the next particular type of throttling policy is the application level throttling policy. In this case, the throttling quota is set per application, and it will be allocated per a user. So what is this also supports both request count and bandwidth based throttling. So in order to identify a particular application instance that is that we are throttling against, the key that is used is the combination of the application ID and the particular authorized user who is using that particular application. So that's how the particular throttling policy will be engaged. And we'll just move on to the custom throttling policies. So apart from the standard throttling policies that we looked at, API Manager allows you to define your own custom throttling policies via writing your own Siddhi script. So these types of throttling policies are only allowed to be added by the system administrator, and they will be applied at a global level across every API. So currently the throttling parameters that are supported for you to actually write policies against are the API context, the API version, the unique resource key, the user ID, the application ID, the API tenant, and the application tenant. So you have access to these parameters that you can use within your custom Siddhi query in order to write various kinds of new throttling logic. And the end result will be a Siddhi query will be generated based on configurations that you provide, and this will be engaged at the traffic manager. So this concludes this lesson where we looked at the overview of the traffic manager and how throttling policies are used in the API Manager product.